in the last video, we saw how blood sugar concentration or glucose concentration in your blood of 80 milligrams per deciliter, 80 milligrams per deciliter, was kind of a normal fasting blood glucose if you hadn't eaten for 8 hours or before a meal. And the fancy word we learned in the last video was preprandial. What I want to do in this video, because 80 milligrams per deciliter really doesn't make a lot of tangible sense to me. I don't know exactly how much sugar that is. What I want to do is try to put this into different units so that we can better conceptualize how much sugar that might be in our body. So let's just do a little bit of unit analysis over here. So if we have 80 milligrams per deciliter, that's what we're talking about. That's a normal fasting blood glucose level. Now let's think about how much that is per liter. A deciliter is a tenth of a liter. So if we want to cancel out the units, we want deciliters. We have deciliters in the denominator here, so we want another deciliter in the numerator. So we want to know deciliters per liter, because then that and that will cancel out. And there are 10 deciliters per liter. There are 10 deciliters per liter, and so that gives us 80 times 10 is 800 milligrams. 800 milligrams per, deciliters cancel out, milligrams per liter. Now if we want that in terms of grams, we can just multiply. We want to get rid of this milligram, so we want that in the denominator. Milligrams, we want grams per milligram. 1 gram is 1,000 milligrams. So once again, milligrams cancel out. And then you have 800 divided by 1,000. So 800 over 1,000 is 0.8 grams per liter. Grams per liter. Let me start over here. So we have 0.8 grams per liter. And then to make sense relative to a normal human body, I looked this up on the internet. The average human body, so you know, I'm assuming I'm like 5'9", 150 pounds, so I think I'm pretty close to average. But they say the average human body has about 5 liters of blood. So let's multiply this times 5 liters per human. Per average human. Obviously, a small human will have less, and a very large person will have more blood flowing through them. But this is an average person right over here. So then we get the liters cancel out. And so we get 0.8 times 5. 8 times 5 is 40. 0.8 times 5, we're going to have one decimal place. It's going to be 4. 0.8 times 5 is 4. And then we have grams per human. 4 grams per human. And just to get an idea of what 4 grams are, one teaspoon is equal to 4.2 grams. So 4 grams is almost a teaspoon. So it's approximately one teaspoon of glucose per human being. So in your entire bloodstream, you have about a teaspoon of sugar that your cells can use to do whatever cells need to do.